let's talk about Berserker a little bit for PvP. Okay, so first let's go through the stances. First one, we have Gale Tactic. Passive effect: when you kill something, you get parry rate and movement speed. I don't meh. Doesn't really matter for PvP, you're not gonna kill that much, honestly. The switch effect, it's got a nice increased parry damage reduction 5%, and especially if you go for this path, you get up to 25% at the moment. It's okay. Increased parry rate effect. Whatever, you know. But overall, I don't think this is really any good for PvP. Like, this whole chain tree is garbage. This whole chain tree is garbage. Only thing going for it is actually this one. Like, the Whirlwind actually does pretty nice damage. If you get like 6 chain, you can crit like 4.5k per hit. And it hit 3 times, so that's actually pretty nice damage. Also, finishing strike is pretty nice skill, in my opinion at least. But yeah, it's not best, but it's not actually as terrible as some people might think. Anger tactic, well, this everyone who played Berserker probably know was pretty much used before. The chances in blood frenzy that you cannot get heals while you have it. It's actually nice. Increased critical hit rate, 4% lost health, and swap. When you swap, you get flat 5% for 5 seconds, and you can increase it up to 9%, which is actually pretty nice upgrade for crit. Here we do have a decapitate for 6 chain possible. RNG bleed, not really. I don't think it's that good. I never fucking get bleed with it. Finishing strike, double earthquake, pretty nice. The pull-in, I actually love the pull-in, but I'm not really using this skill myself, like, because the bleed change. But pull-in into slash into uplift, upper swing, it's pretty nice. Has some CC, it's okay-ish if you wanna use it. Slaughter tactic, I think this is pretty good for PvP. It like gives you rage, anger when you enter battle or fight, whatever you call it, battle mode. Up to 30, which is what you need for forestallment. Like, straight away you can go into combat and do forestallment. Like, it's pretty nice, I think it's good. Also, when you switch out of it, you get 0.1% HP per anger. So basically, if you're full 100 anger and switch out, you heal 10% and up to like 14%. Wait, 16%, 18%, something like that. It's alright. Here we have like this is not too bad, but not really using it. Decrease fighting power for enemies. Of course, Rambling Ground with stun, really nice. We have decap 4 chain, can do pretty nice damage. Or start like quick tap into finishing strike, I like it. This is also decent damage, but I don't really use Skullcrusher. Long to charge, fuck it. Assault, really nice. Leap, stun, long range into uplift, upper swing, whatever. Knock up, nice CC. You can also knock down enemies if you want. I think this actually is a bit more damage if you go stump, but whatever. I don't usually use stump, I usually go for the upswing, so I put points in it anyway. This heal, 10% of your damage dealt heals you like, what the fuck, 80 fucking HP, what the fuck ever. Rampage tactic. Oh, this is like the best thing ever. AoE knockup. Earthquake. Fucking nice. Charge stance. It's pretty slow, I think. You don't use too much. Just 3 seconds for... It's 10% crit and fighting power, but... it's kind of slow to cast. And then you need to do whirlwind in to get into 6 chains, or you're in 3 seconds, you're... gonna be fast if you wanna, like, keep it on your 6 chains, so... I don't know, Rhapsody is shit skill, but... we have to use it in here. Slaughter tactic. Usually I go for the pull-in. Unfortunately this pull-in is a bit buggy, so like sometimes it pulls the targets together, sometimes it doesn't, like it's doesn't work as well as in fucking anger tactic. This pull-in doesn't do it, this always pulls it. This sometimes even they don't toughness it, it doesn't some reason pull them. Really, but what is nice on this is the 10% physical defense decrease on enemies who you pull. It's pretty nice. Then we have like another decrease fighting power. If you wanna go for it, you have chance to bleed. You have finishing strike. I usually go for this if I wanna use it, this chain. You buff your strength, and then you fighting power, and then you slam the finishing strike. Here, like Furious Strike, Ancho Strike, pretty decent damage. Here, if you're below 50% HP, you can get bleeds instantly. Situational. But, of course, the 6 chain. Decapitate, JJK crits, fun times. Everybody loves it, but what really makes a Rampage tactic awesome, in my opinion, is like this effect, chase effect. Like this increased skill damage based on your HP loss. It's kinda whatever. You're usually quite healthy in fights anyway, like you're constantly getting heals. But the switch effect reduces all defenses 10%. Increase fighting power 30%, and you can increase it like up to 50% fighting power increase, and same time decreasing your defense 30%. High risk, high reward gives you massive boost in damage. It's just like bread and butter for me. And of course, I'm not a pussy. I go to the full risk. With defense decrease in this one. I will talk about bit later about how to I use it really. Then let's go to non-chain skills. Unyielding fighter. This is kinda shitty skill how it works. It's only 3 seconds. So short you can't get the full 6 chains out of it. Some HP recovery. Who cares? More attack power if you're low. Yeah, it's a huge boost if you're low, but fuck you. You're not gonna use it, get it offline. Never. You will be dead if you're that low. Also, the immunity path, it's not proactive. You have to use it reactive, like when you're 5% or below. Or when you're below 5%, then you use it, then you get the immunity. Otherwise, you just heal 10%. Fucking basically use. I test game changer. Game changer. I have tested it quite a bit in mass PvP or PGs. I can't really justify it either. Like it's the crit person doesn't really. Like you don't really see the difference in the fighting power. Hard to say. It's kinda meh. And the battle rate special is like garbage. Whatever. Dodge roll. I think the fighting power one is pretty okay. Like, it's huge buff, it lasts like 5 seconds. Health roll, it's my personal favorite. It's like bit pussy, but works for me. Other thing would be use it without anything, having 30 second rolls. It's pretty nice. Dodge movement enchantment with the parry rate. I tested it, it's not really that nice. Like, the only cool thing about this actually would be actually, let me show you. Like, if we use it with the veteran. And then roll, our parry rate goes to 99%. Which is a lot. For a while. Gives you nice damage. Damage reduction, like, makes you a bit tanky, like 3 second intervals. Up to 4. Like, still parry, it's kinda fucking shit. Then it's over and I prefer the health one, personally. Veteran. I don't really like it, how it's working at the moment. Like, you switch the stance, you lose the buff, but still your range gets drained out. Kinda sucky, I don't like losing my range for nothing. Or anger, sorry. Health recovery path. Not really enough in PvP. Fighting power. Yeah, kinda nice, but then again, breaks chain, you gonna switch, you lose it. You can only use it for theory chain. Kinda meh. Resistance, crowd control skills, better rate increase. Yeah, it makes you actually quite tanky against physical opponents, but I don't really like the other things, like draining my rage out when after I switch stance, losing the buff. Just personally don't really like it how it's working at the moment. Fighting spirit, 3 seconds fighting power increase, too short time, I don't like it. Additional rage, anger, fucking rage. Anger increase, don't really need it, the 40 default gives enough. The heal, it's pretty nice, like if you get max rage, heal 45% health back, nice heal, juicy. Personally I don't use it, I use the healing roll instead, I think it's enough, cause usually I'm not alone anyway, I have Paladin healing me. Fighter's Will, it's basically, you already get it from your Rampage tactic, it's the same kind of thing. Reduce your defense, increase your fighting power, but it's less, it's good, risky. I don't personally use it, but the other ones give your Blood Frenzy. What the fuck would you give yourself a Blood Frenzy? Blood Leads. Why the fuck would you give yourself a blood bleed like that? Like, fuck it, no. Malevolence. I personally like this skill. Gives 30% physical defense reduction and movement speed reduction for enemies. And you can increase it up to 50% and 40. Both 50% physical defense reduction and movement speed reduction if you go full. This bar is just physical 50. It's pretty nice. I like the slow. Helps to sometimes keep on a target. And it's pretty nice debuff to give if you have like more jerkers fighting around you. The fighting power is also nice, but it decreases your defenses so much compared to what you gain on your fighting power. I'm not sure if it's worth it. The dot aura thingy, it does do little damage to be like really viable, in my opinion at least. And finally, forced element. Knockback. Karame. Root. Karame. Knockdown. Really, really nice. It's long knockdown. Up to 4 seconds. Personally, I don't need the cooldown reduction. I have the weapon to reduce it for 10 seconds already, so I have it almost always available when I need it. Especially because it costs 30 anger, so that's about it. Then the abilities. Personally, I think this is the best one. I'm not sure if the 3% damage is better or the 50. I haven't really actually tested. This other option would basically to drop these and pick these and this. Actually, I have more this stuff than normally, but yeah. Other option would be to drop these and pick these to be like a bit more consistent on your damage. But the crit damage, like this, I think it's better because sustain damage is not so good. Game is really burst heavy, like you want to burst your targets. Fallen is here so much, like you just need to burst through. Sustain damage, they never are gonna run out. Mana, there's no dampening, there's no nothing, like you just need burst. And this is what gives you burst when you crit 10% more. So, basically, what I run is Forest Element, Fighting Spirit, Malevolence, Dodge Roll for the health, max cooldown reduction, Spernal Preference, I could use this one for the extra damage. Could use this one, I don't mind. Personally not fan of it. I think I get more out of this. And I don't think I get more out of giving myself anger more frequently than heals. But let's talk about the actual skills that we gonna spam all the time. It's for me Slaughter Tactic and Rampage Tactic. Why? I love having the two leaps. And we have option to 6 chain decap. With full buffs, good runes, 30k crits. Fucking love it. Nice as hell. Keys of Anger passively in battlegrounds. You gonna enter up and leave fights like all the time when your teammates enter fights and so forth. So you get free anger all the time. Really, really nice in my opinion. This does actually pretty good damage. And it's nice CC, it's stun into scratch into up knock up. Nice, very nice CC. Then we have 4 chain. Cap option here, or start like give little tap, boom, finishing strike. Nice. Then of course we have our Rhapsody, one of the most serious skill we can ever use. Rapid attack and Rambling Ground. About 5 seconds stun. But the other option is to increase the stun duration to 1.5 seconds. Personally, I just slammed it on the damage. I did play with the increased stun duration before, but I actually don't really need it for the purpose I use this chain. Like, of course, 6 chain. Decap, very nice. But you're always not gonna be able to pull it off. Okay then. And right, here was the defense decrease with the knockup. This is good damage. Knockup, love it. Into rapid attack, into pull, mainly for the physical defense reduction. Then when I swap to 6 stance, I get the 50% fighting power. I slam into Rhapsody into fucking huge earthquake, rambling ground, whatever, motherfuckers. And you can like with full buffs, paladin buff, like 18k up to 18k, you can like slam this shit out of nowhere, like instantly, like bam. Really, really nice. My personal favorite, like just slamming the ground randomly, critting mates to 15k and bye bye. Love it. Fuck you. Yeah, then of course we have the finishing strike, like as a filler. Does nice damage. And that's about it.